Let today we will see fourth Gauss's application. In this application, we find electric field intensity due to thin infinite sheet of charge. To find it, we took a infinite sheet which is uniformly charged. That means Q amount of charge is uniformly distributed over it. Then the surface charge density of the sheet is sigma, that is charge per unit area is sigma. Now we took a two points at a equidistance from the charge sheet in opposite direction. Both points are perpendicular to the sheet. That is, let P and Q be the two points from the equidistance of the sheet, and it is also perpendicular to the sheet, and the distance between them is 2R. That is, distance between PQ is 2R. Now we forming a cylinder of cross sectional area ds and length 2R. Since it is clear both the point is perpendicular to the sheet and equidistance from it, and we make a cylinder, it is also perpendicular to the sheet. Therefore, the line of forces passes through the both edges, but it is not passes through the curved surface of the cylinder, because the area element, the direction of area element is parallel to the sheet, but the direction of electric field intensity perpendicular to the sheet. So it makes angle 90 degree on the curved surface of the cylinder. Therefore, flux passing through the curved surface area is EDS cos 90 degree equal to 0. Now we see in the agents. The direction of electric field E and the area element ds, both are in the same direction. That is, the electric flux passing through the one edge is integration over closed surface eds, and also the electric field intensity passing through the other edge is integration over closed surface eds. Therefore, total electric flux passing through the both edges is equal to 2 into integration over closed surface vector E dot vector ds, or we can write E ds cos theta. Here theta is 0 degree, so we write E ds cos 0 degree equal to 2 E ds. Then net or resultant flux passing through the Gaussian cylindrical surface is phi E is equal to 2 E ds. There are no contribution of flux through the curved surface of the cylinder. Therefore, total electric charge enclosed by cylinder is equal to sigma ds. Here again, we use the concept of surface charge density. Since we know that surface charge density sigma is equal to Q by surface area, then Q is equal to sigma into surface area. Here our surface area is cross-sectional area is ds, so Q is equal to sigma ds. Putting there, since sigma E is equal to since phi E equal to 2 E ds equal to Q by epsilon naught according to Gauss theorem. Putting the value of Q is equal to sigma ds, then we can write 2 E ds equal to sigma ds by epsilon naught. Therefore, E equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. It is the equation for the electric field intensity due to single infinite charge when the points lie on some distance from the seat and it is also perpendicular in terms of surface charge density. It's all for